What is up, guys? Welcome to part one of making the Miata a Miata again. But today's video, we are just gonna be taking everything off that we need to pull the motor and trans tomorrow. So currently right now, we've taken the radiator out, the front bumper, and the two fenders off. And we're currently trying to take the exhaust off right now too. And then our next plan for tonight is we're gonna be taking the wiring from inside the car and we're gonna leave everything plugged in on the motor just because it'll be a lot easier for the next person who ever wants or is gonna be taking this motor for the full kit. So it'll be easier for them to know how everything's plugged in and they don't have to do it themselves. So make it a little bit easier for the next person. But we're gonna be taking everything, I guess, inside the car and lay it on top of the motor.
So we're taking the exhaust off now. There's one hanger right there that we already took off. And then we got the hanger back here. It's just a rubber mount. It's a rubber mount, and then you can't see it, but it's pretty dark back here. And then the whole thing is just one piece that we'll take off.
Yeah, we might have to drop that because it's all one piece. We'll probably have to drop it after we pull the motor. I don't know. Past that subframe because it's 3-inch all the way back.
Well, it's more so just like the fuel lines right there.
Yeah, because it's hanging down right now, but
I think you're gonna have to move it over towards the center of the car.
Well, it's a 3-inch like down. Right.
Next step is we're gonna be removing this so you got the front bolts off, and then we're gonna be able to get the carpet out here. And that will give us access to the wiring down there that we're gonna all detach the wiring and then feed it through the firewall, like I said.
Dope. That wasn't too bad.
That was gonna be a lot harder. Should've taken the hardtop off first.
Yeah, that's true. It'd probably been a lot easier to take the hardtop off. Oh man, no seat in there now. Oh shoot, there's a wrench in there too.
That's my wrench. That's my wrench, man.
Oh, okay. Never mind.
I'm trying to take my wrench.
Oh dude, so crusty in there. Need to vacuum that crap.
No, you don't.
I know, right? That's been like that for a really long time.
How you doing?
Hey. Oh, you're wet. You've been outside, haven't you? Yeah, so we gotta take all the carpet out. We're gonna take the dash out, and then also, like, we have to take all this carpet out and everything to get to the whole entire harness that goes all the way back to the battery, because we're gonna be replacing that back all with the whole stock Miata harness. So gotta take this plastic piece off, and then so we can start taking the carpet out. But I'm gonna have to get a new plate right here for the ECU for the Mega Squirt, but that's a bummer that I don't have that one anymore.
That's fine if you can get it in there like that.
Slowly but surely.
Well, we're gonna have to undo this light and this light and the.
For the cigarette lighter?
Yeah.
Okay. How's the best way to lift it up, I guess? Just.
Yeah. Go back in the
see that. Where'd you light it?
Light it. Hopefully it doesn't roll on this. E-brake is not making this.
Open. There you go.
Oh. Oh.
What's it called on here?
What was it? This thing that he did and this thing that he did.
Yeah, that's for like
that's nice. What's your steering cluster?
What do you mean my steering cluster?
Your blinker.
Alright.
You wanna put it?
Well, it didn't crack.
Back in the truck? No.
The hood's already in the truck.
I guess shut the door first.
I can't shut the door with you, Michael.
That's true.
Come on, pick up.
Okay, you got it.
I got it.
Yeah.
Up.
I got it.
Taking the shifter out now on the boot. I'm gonna have to get an NV1. Don't work on the NV1.
V transmissions.
This one's also a little,
Yeah, I'm gonna need to replace it anyway. It's pretty jank.
It's, not there anymore.
Yeah. Got the dash out.
A lot of room for activities down here. As you can see, like, my fuse box from where it usually is in a stock Miata, it's in the engine bay, but it's down here now because the engine bay is wire tucked and everything.
But, and you can also see, like, there's a hole right there on the side, and then there's wire tucked in the fenders. So you're just saying, like, I'm surprised that this 5-speed is held up over being boosted and just being destroyed. And what, Dale, you drained it, right? What did you say?
Yeah, there was a lot of metal.
Dude, I'm like, these are Miata transmissions, man. I don't know. This is a 5-speed, but I've
Have you seen the video of me driving this car?
Oh, dude, Kevin. I taught Kevin how to drive stick on this thing.
It's probably all the metal for
dude,
me.
Dude, all the drive. Was it like chunks or what?
Nah, dude, the shavings. Drain plug looked like a porcupine, dude. Like,
oh!
Dude. It looked like a CVT from Nissan, dude, I swear.
Oh, dang, bro. That's crazy. Well, whoever gets this tranny, they might want to replace it. But I mean, hey, it still worked perfectly fine. Alright guys, that pretty much wraps it up for this video. We got a lot done tonight. Here, let me show you real quick. So, like, we got the dash out, got the turret off, and then got the center console, and then we kind of were just looking at the wiring, what we're going to have to do to put it back to a stock Miata. And then we also got the radiator, like we said, fenders off. So we made pretty good progress, and then tomorrow we're going to be pulling the trans, the motor, and then I think Yanni's going to be over here. He's going to be checking out the wiring and what we're going to have to do to put the NB harness in. So stay tuned, guys. Make sure to give a big thumbs up, and it's coming along. We're coming. This is the part one. Part two is going to be pulling the motor and trans. But hope you guys are enjoying this content so far. But as always, GPG, like, comment, and subscribe. And peace out, guys. See you in the next one.